2K Sports pregame.
practicing with Bradley Beal's mom, because she has definitely honed something special into him.
To be sure. I'm just not sure some of the more delicate NBA egos can handle her trash talking once you can tell them to be
Well, not exactly a close game so far, but as the second quarter starts here, plenty of time for a comeback. And what stands out to you from Washington in this one?
Through that first one, they've turned this thing into a track meet.
I'll tell you, they've simply been more assertive in the open floor. They're leaking out early, converting with confidence.
Frazier is out there with Jody Meeks. Then there's Oubre. Then there's Ian Mahina. And Scott in at the four. That's the group starting the second quarter for the Wizards. Mahina's shot is good.
Morris.
Here's Scott. Another one falls for Russia. course, Mahimi is not a flashy player by any means.
Right. Giannis is a guy who needs to be flashy in order to impact the game. He does a terrific job filling up space on the offensive end when teams collapse off him. And this guy's got a great career field goal percentage because he takes only the shots he knows he can make.
Looking at who's out there now for the Wizards. Morris is checked in for Scott. Otto Porter Jr. comes in for Oubre, and Zadaransky subbed in for Frazier. Austin shooting their first free throw attempt on the night. Washington leading now by 8. Zadaransky, the pass to Mahimi. It's stolen by Brown. And a fast break now for the Celtics. Tice tips down the breakaway slam.
I think Brown demonstrating he's got a great understanding of the game. He keeps his head moving, his eyes open so he can stop the open man.
And pushing it up, here's Boston. Pulls up from the corner. Second chance effort. He takes it up and lays it in. 7 points in the game.
And they repeatedly crossed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Mahimi a screen, and Zadaransky kicks to Porter. Mahimi with a screen for Porter. Over Tatum, and another miss by Washington.
Off that screen, wide open, just can't convert.
I think, Greg, that's exactly what you want. The screen was solid, the execution just fell a little bit short on the shot.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and getting scoring effectively from the paint.
Zadaransky kicks to Mahimi. In the corner, it's Morris. Hits the 3-point pop. Morris has got himself on the board with 3 there.
Now, one of the more valuable things in basketball, bigs who can stretch the defense. Morris, one of those guys.
Washington leading now by 5. Zadaransky, the pass to Porter. And Shu Larkin gets the whistle that time. Washington making some changes. Hortons checked in for Mahimi, and Beal subbed in for Jody Meeks. Now here's Beal. He had a 30-point outing their last game against the 76ers in Philadelphia.
You know, he was also one of their key contributors on the glass. His effort was terrific.
The shot by Zadaransky, no good.
That's what we're talking about in terms of the activity level defensively. They've got to protect the rim.
No, exactly, Greg. Especially when the ball is that deep inside, you've got to respect how he altered that shot. Well, the 3-pointer, right? A much more significant piece of the Celtics offense. They went from middle of the pack to top 3 in makes from deep last year.
One shot misses. Here's the Celtics with the ball. They're on a 12-3 run.
Great look on that. Just a little out of rhythm.
Yeah, he looked like he forced it.
No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. And Beal kicks to Zadaransky. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Morris with a screen on Irving. Zadaransky tries to save it. And again, Washington, no good. And for the Celtics last season, they're 3-point again. Another unleashed chaos moment. Here's Zadaransky, who's averaging around 5.5 points a game. Morris dishes the Gortat. Back in off the glass. Gortat's got 8.
How about the vision of Markieff Morris? It's the open man, has a good feel for the game. But this guy can do a lot of things.
Beal against Brown. Six to shoot. And Gortat kicks to Morris. Here's Beal with a 3. That shot, no good. And the Celtics going the other way now.
And we haven't seen them be quite as aggressive driving basketball. Settling far too much.
Yeah. And it's Brown missing. The Wizards with the lead. Outside, Gordon. Beal loses to Morris.
Welcome back, everybody. It's the halftime show on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson here with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Things were going Washington's way from the beginning. Some lights-out offense and defense on display as they went on an 11-0 run to start. And it was a 9-point lead for them as they finished the first quarter. Going into the second quarter, they lost a little focus, sacrificed some points, but still finished with a 4-point cushion at the half. And let's get your thoughts, Kenny. And that is just about going to wrap it up as the second half is moments away. Down to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the group.
Say through the post.
Do you think we could reinvent Hakeem Olajuwon or perhaps Patrick Ewing or
Bill
Russell?
I wish we could.
Good point. Every time I walk by a pickup game on the outside, you see guys sprinting to the three-point line and looking to Steph Curry.
On the court for the Celtics, Irving and Brown pair at the one and the two. Horford is out there with Aaron Baines, and it's Tatum in at the three spot. And last season, Greg, you heard a lot of names brought up for most improved player in the league, and Otto Porter was one of them.
I mean, and I think for Porter, the change came when he just felt more comfortable from deep in terms of shooting. He always had a solid mid-range game, but now he looks comfortable from deep, and has become one of the bigger threats we have in the league.
Here's Sadoransky. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Here's the screen. Here's Beal from 13 feet. It goes down. And the Wizards lead by five.
He's gotten a little bit more selective with his two-point jumpers, but that's a shot Beal hits with regularity.
Puts it up. Will not go. This is off the front iron. The Wizards shooting here about 46% for the game. And now the fast break, Irving with the ball, and the layup falls. Irving's got five now.
Well, the quick hands of Irving to help create offense for himself on the other end.
And that replay brought to us by Under Armour. Another Unleash Chaos moment. One of the more exciting plays in basketball. And Zadoransky kicks to Morris. No good on the triple. Celtics trail by three. Tatum wide open, he fires one. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. Irving's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Here's Sadoransky, and stolen by Kyrie Irving. For the lead, and there are the Celtics with another basket.
Guys, we know Kyrie can score from anywhere on the floor, including the mid-range.
Here's Sadoransky, covered by Irving. Outside, Porter. Five to shoot. Just got the run. And again, Washington, no good.
Okay, he has been cold for a while.
Washington making some changes. Miami comes in for Cortat. And it's Jody Meeks in for Bradley Beal.
Now, Irving is so versatile as a scorer. Outstanding free throw shooter, too.
And Shane Larkin gets the whistle that time. That's foul number two for him. Not quite 2.5 minutes play here in the second half. Miami a screen. And Meeks kicks to Morris. Fade away. Count that one. Morris has got his second basket of the night.
Great shooting touch and face-up game opportunities for a power forward. Morris deadly from mid-range. Well, one thing we know about this Wizards team, they have no problem putting points on the board. Last year, they were fifth in the league in points per game. Offense was the strength of this team. Now, can they put together a little bit on the defensive end?
Zaransky picks for Morris. Feeds away. Bounces high off the rim and drops. Morris has got seven.
It seems every year Markieff Morris gets a little more consistent with the jumper. Looks so comfortable there.
Irving double team. And here we go. Washington fast break.
How about the shot? Looks like they're
we've been waiting for one of these teams, Greg, to pull away. Maybe that'll be a springboard for them.
Yeah, a big change of possession in a tight ball game. We'll see if they've seized the momentum.
So, timeout call here. And for the Wizards and their offense, Doris, it starts at the backcourt, but they can hurt you at a lot of positions.
Right, Kev, because they had six players averaging double-figure points last season. It's a very strong passing team. They can score inside, they can score outside, and no lead is safe when they are getting shots to fall.
And again, Washington, no good.
Well, I mean, you want to give your offense a chance, and that possession did good.
Reason for him to be taking these kinds of shots. He has only himself to blame.
Zaransky, the pass to Frazier. It's good. 5 points in the game.
And you have to admire his focus. Not a good matchup for him in terms of size differential.
No, but that play is about his will, right? He won't back down from the big man. He's going to take it right to him.
Wizards trail by five. Pass to Zaransky. The kick out to Scott. Second chance effort, and it's Frazier getting it to go. Frazier's got 4 points in the quarter.
Hey, guys, the defense has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip.
Can get to go.
And they had some nice trouble that turned into no trouble.
Pass to Zaransky. They set the screen. Here's Frazier. Another miss by Frazier. Celtics leading by three. Here's Rozier. It's good from long range. Rozier's got five.
Boy, late on rotations, not quite.
Dishes to Moore. That one, no good. Good work defensively by Monroe.
And this is obviously where you'd like to see a 2-for-1.
Absolutely.
Out of bounds, Boston takes possession. For Washington. And Leveal comes in for Zaransky. And then for Boston, Horford comes in for. And it's Brown in for Shane Larkin. Boston shooting from the field, 44%, not bad. For three, good on the triple. And the Celtics lead by nine.
The defense a step slow. You can see the results.
1 second separating the shot clock and game. Now here's Frazier. He's starting closer. There's a steal by Gorton. Six to shoot. They get the rebound. This is good. And so is the Boston Celtics. A hit by nine as the quarter comes to a close. They've enacted hands in a forced day and one in this one. We've got more in store for you right after this. Possession. 9-point game. Frazier and Beal are in the backcourt. Oubre out there with Scott. And it's Fortot in at the five spot. That's the five on a 4 for the Wizards. And here's Morris for three. Shot clock reset for the Celtics. Rozier kicks to Horford. Shoots over Scott. Horford, no luck.
Well, he hasn't been a big contributor tonight, for sure. But it hasn't prevented them from being in a position to grab the win.
Gortat. And so he earns a trip to the line. Official shot the contact, and he'll shoot two.
This guy will mix it up on the inside.
And it's the little things that Martin Gortat is so good at that helps you at that center position. His awareness of space, strong in the pick and roll, and also a solid finisher at the rim.
Adoransky's checked in for Frazier. They can't make the second free throw either. Missing both. And with Gortat, it's those little things like Sipton Tomley's screens or Greg moving to open up room for others that make him so valuable.
Kevin, he is deadly in the pick and roll. One of the best screeners in terms of his effectiveness to create space. And usually, he's near the top of the league in terms of baskets that are created off of his screen.
Here's the screen. There's Peele with the three. It's good from long range.
He hits from the first half, another here. Not prolific, but the defense has to keep an eye on it.
Jacks up a three. Kick out to Brown. And it'll be blocked as it goes out of bounds. And Washington making a change. Porter's checked in. And the Celtics also making a change. Tatum, he's checked in for Marcus Morris. Beal with the steal. Here's Sadoransky. And the Wizards hit again from deep.
This guy's got the green light at any time. Beal with the nice look to set up the open shot.
And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the content. It's on Kelly Oubre.
Number three overall back in 2016. Jaylen Brown with a powerful build on the wing, guys. 6'7", 233 pounds. I think you need those perimeter defenders who combine quickness and strength, and he's got it.
And ball. And Doris, coming out of Calvert, the knock on Brown was his shooting time.
You know, there was such a wide variety of features in the draft. Some felt that he was a little bit of a reach, but this guy has shown promise. Having regular minutes and having some success with that three-pointer and athleticism.
Their game plan needs to change.
Into the fourth quarter in this one. Tatum passes to Horford. Basket is good, and he'll get a chance for one more free throw on.
And they shot just over 30% in that first half. Not what they were looking for, obviously, but they're getting much better here since halftime and have brought that percentage up.
And Doris, as great as Al Horford is as a player, he might be even a better leader.
Well, he's a pro's pro. Al Horford is a guy who entered the league with great work habits and great skill. More than anything to me, though, it's his poise and calm demeanor under pressure that gives his teammates a ton of confidence.
Free throw drive for Al Horford.
Well, there's so much to like about Al Horford's game, right? He's a superb shooter. He's an excellent passer, very high basketball IQ.
to be the man on the team that can contend for a championship. And you might question how he went about it, but he's basically been a pro in his approach, and now he's got the chance.
This, to me, is one of Bradley Beal's advantages. The defense has got to respect the perimeter jump shot, and that sets up that triple drive.
And the shot goes in. Irving's got four this quarter.
What a turnaround in the second half. So much more accurate overall.
And there is going to be a lot of discussion over Irving's decision to run out for a long time. And what he does the next few years may end up defining his legacy. And he is all in on himself, and it could pay off huge for his life. And offensively, they seem to have turned a corner.
Wizards trail by eight. And we're over 3.5 minutes in the books so far here in the fourth. And the officials have called the Olympics for
nothing. That's just something. I mean, you can't lose control of the ball like that and let it get back across midcourt.
You know, I guess the only good thing about it is it didn't turn into a fast break the other way. Dead ball turnover.
The train. Again, Irving missing. For the Wizards, this one's not looking good. Porter takes the deal, takes a three. And again, Washington, no good.
You know, regularized threes isn't how you want to close the gap. You've got to have better protection. You'll never see too many guys who can put forth a depth on the boards like this one.
Yeah, his production is complicated, but really a testament to how much he cares about his career.
There's a minute 40 left in the fourth quarter. Kyrie Irving really making a difference here.
Well, he has got to be the only thing they're discussing in this huddle because the approach
that
you
want to make. You need to have something because you don't have to put off until
he's done.
Thank you.
for Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Alden. This is Kevin Harlan saying...
Yesterday. Yep, camera.